Hope you are safe and well. I am Mehla Devi from Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, Coimbatore, and I'm here to present on antibiotic elimination of endosymbionts interferes with the Paracoccus marginatus oviposition development and reproduction. So, as that of in many sucking insects, mealybugs also carries an organ called bacterium, inside which it has n number of bacteriocytes fully packed with endosymbionts. In case of papaya mealybug here, the green cells represents the primary endosymbionts, that is Tremblaya, inside whose cytoplasm it actually houses the many secondary endosymbionts belongs to the gamma proteobacterial subdivision. And these symbionts helps the papaya mealybug in both defense and nutrition role. Since this papaya mealybug is a highly polyphagous insect capable of infesting n number of host plants, it keep on increasing its host range, and in order to adapt to that host plant, it needs to co-evolve with the defense offered by those host plants. Hence, in accordance with those with that co-evolution, both primary and secondary endosymbionts also tend to co-evolve naturally. Hence, disruption of these microbial symbiosis demanded by these insect pests is the recent trend in managing this pest. Hence, here we attempted to disrupt the microbial symbiosis in papaya mealybug through antibiotic afloxacin treatment. Here we followed the methods given by Douglas in the year 1996, which was that antibiotic treatment via host plants. So once after the administration of antibiotic treatment was done, both a control and treated population was subjected to the metagenomic analysis on nanopore platform. It is done to know the whole endosymbiotic profile of both control and treated population. And here we could found that the primary endosymbiont genus Tremblaya was naturally tend to be abundant, with 75% of abundance occupying the major portion of the bacterium, followed by 50% abundant in Mikkella, followed by 4% Pseudomonas, and others contributing 1% each. Whereas when it is treated with the antibiotic, there has been the reduction in the load of the endosymbionts was noticed. That is, the primary endosymbiont Tremblaya's abundance was reduced from 75 to 34% and Mikkella's from 15 to 8%, and the Pseudomonas was found to be completely eliminated. And some of the secondary endosymbionts like Wolbachia, Bacillus, Escherichia, Edwardsiella, Salmonella, which was found in meager amount, that is near to 1% or less than 1% abundance in case of controlled population, was found to took upper hand, and they tend to increase their abundance and occupies the bacterium. So these strains may be tolerant to the particular antibiotic, that is afloxacin, used in our study. And the primary inoculum or primary source of these endosymbiont is the host plants. Hence, the secondary endosymbionts identified in our present study has been compared with the bacterial endophytes that was reported earlier. And it confirms that majority of the endophytes present in the papaya host plant has been transported via food, and they entered into the mealybug system, and after several infection, they acquired the state of symbiont. And hence, after the elimination of endosymbiont, what happens to the population and reproductive parameters of the papaya mealybug? Here we found that both mean generation time and population doubling time has been prolonged once after the elimination of endosymbionts. So it takes prolonged time to complete its generation. And when we look into the net reproductive rate, in case of naturally, the papaya mealybug could one female of the papaya mealybug could able to produce up to 40 number per lifetime. However, when their endosymbionts got eliminated or they have been reduced through antibiotic treatment, it could able to produce only 21 numbers per lifetime. And when we look into the survivability of these treated population, the reduced survival at the initial stage is a common phenomenon in all the insects, whereas the highly reduced survival of these first instar nymphs has been attributed to the mortality of the eggs that was actually was the result of endosymbiotic elimination. And also the second reason is that the first instar nymphs is the actually active stage of the mealybugs, and they tend to crawl along the plant host in order to find the perfect host tissue for its feeding, and in that process they tend to tumbling off, and only those individuals they get the opportunity to get climb back the plant will only have the